Hello again. I am at present still on film, but in a few seconds, I should be appearing in the studio. Thank you.
Hello.
Mr. Milton, you are sole proprietor and owner of the Whizzo Chocolate Company.
I am.
Superintendent Parrott and I are from the Hygiene Squad. We want to have a word with you about your box of chocolates entitled The Whizzo Quality Assortment.
Ah, yes.
If I may begin at the beginning. First, there is the cherry fondue.
Oh.
This is extremely nasty, but we can't prosecute you for that.
Agreed.
Next, we have number four. Crunchy frog.
Ah, yes.
Am I right in thinking there's a real frog in here?
Yes, a little one.
What sort of frog?
A dead frog.
Is it cooked?
No.
What, a raw frog?
We use only the finest baby frogs, dew-picked and flown from Iraq, cleansed in the finest quality spring water, lightly killed, and then sealed in a succulent Swiss quintuple smooth triple cream milk chocolate envelope and lovingly frosted with glucose.
This is maybe instead of frog.
Oh, what else?
Well, don't you even take the bones out?
If we took the bones out, it wouldn't be crunchy, would it?
Superintendent Parrott ate one of those.
Excuse me a moment. It says crunchy frog quite clearly.
Well, the superintendent thought it was an almond whirl. People won't expect there to be a frog in there. They're bound to think it's some form of mock frog.
Mock frog? We use no artificial preservatives or additives of any kind.
Nevertheless, I must warn you that in future you should delete the words crunchy frog and replace them with the legend crunchy, raw, unboned, real, dead frog if you want to avoid prosecution.
What about our sales?
I'm not interested in your sales. I have to protect the general public. Now, how about this one? It was number five, wasn't it? Number five, Ram's Bladder Cup. What kind of confection is this?
We use choicest juicy chunks of fresh Cornish ram's bladder, emptied, steamed, flavoured with sesame seeds, whipped into a fondue and garnished with lark's vomit.
Lark's vomit?
Correct.
Well, it don't say nothing about that here.
Oh, yes it does. On the bottom of the box, after monosodium glutamate.
Well, I hardly think this is good enough. I think it would be more appropriate if the box bore a large red label warning lark's vomit.
Our sales would plummet.
Well, why don't you move into more conventional areas of confectionery, like praline or lime cream, a very popular flavour I'm led to understand. I mean, look at this one. Cockroach cluster. Anthrax ripple. What's this one? Spring surprise.
Oh, that's our speciality. Covered in darkest creamy chocolate, when you pop it in your mouth, steel bolts spring out and plunge straight through both cheeks.
Well, where's the pleasure in that? If people place a nice chocky in their mouths, they don't want their cheeks pierced. In any case, this is an inadequate description of the sweetmeat. I should have to ask you to accompany me to the station.
It's a fair cop.
Stop talking to the camera.
I'm sorry.
If only the general public would take more care when buying its sweeties, it would reduce the number of man-hours lost to the nation, and they would spend less time having their stomachs pumped and sitting around in public lavatories.